What's going on YouTube? Jason right here. So in today's video we're talking about a must-have application for your jailbroken device. And that is of course the iSecure OS, which has been updated and it has more features than ever. Since I made my last video about iSecure OS, a lot has changed. The application got updated a lot and it's now fully open source. So you don't have to trust me, you can compile it yourself and of course you can analyze the code. Now this is an application I made, so if you want to try it out, definitely do so. It's basically an anti-malware slash security advisory application for your jailbroken device that you can get directly from Cydia through my repo. So as you can see here, I have my repo, which is iSecureOS security repo. Basically, the repo address is iSecureOS.idevicecentral.com/repo. And here I have a pirate repo, which contains, of course, a lot of stuff. Now, I only use that for demonstration purposes in here. Now, many people believe that every single pirate repo will be taken as malware and stuff like that. So the application would basically consider everything to be bad. Well, it doesn't. If the application says you have malware on your device, it means you have malware. The pirate repos are indeed detected, but not as malware. They just tell you that they are unsafe. So if you press here and perform a security scan on your jailbroken device, as you can see, it only takes a few seconds. Of course, the application was updated. It used to take more. And now if you press view vulnerabilities here, you can see that the Chemo repo is definitely detected in Cydia here. And it tells me that it's an unsafe repo, but it doesn't tell me it's malware. However, if you have actual malware detected by iSecureOS, in that case it would tell you that it's malware. So the application only detects malware if you really have it. Now aside from that, aside from the security advisory in here, which tells you that you have the default SSH password, you are not using a VPN, CVE vulnerabilities that you have on your version and so on, you can also change your SSH password directly from the application. And this would change the password for both root and mobile. And since my last video about iSecureOS, I have added something new. The option to rescan after you did a scan. You can also do a deep scan if you want to and so on. And of course now there's this gear here and you have the option to reset the SSH password. This is basically in case you forgot your password. You press in here and it would become again the default Alpine password. And here we have an important thing. Remove quarantined items. So when this application finds malware when it scans, it automatically gets it into a quarantine so that it doesn't affect your device anymore. And it's no longer able to run that malware, so it would basically be on the file system, but it would be completely harmless. However, if you want to clear that out, you don't want those on the file system at all, you press remove quarantined items and that's basically it. It will clean up completely everything it found. And I also added some settings here for those of you who don't want the information about the CVEs, because many of you told me that, well, if the only way to fix those is to update iOS, then I would like to filter them out. I would like to know about them once and then of course filter them out, and now you can. So if you rescan, the CVEs no longer pop up in here. You only get the actual vulnerabilities. I'm gonna press here and save the report, and you can see that we have the default SSH password detected. All you would have to do is to press change and set a new password here. For example, I'm going to say 2000. And I'm gonna say space 2000 again here. And then I'm gonna press secure this device. And it says root password is now updated. So at this point, if I do a rescan, it should not find the vulnerability again. And there you go. The only vulnerability right now that I have on this device is that I have a pirate repo. And these repos tend to be outdated a lot. They tend to have a lot of outdated binaries and they also tend to have malware from time to time. So it's really a good idea to not use them, or if you use them, to be very, very careful. So I'm gonna remove this one here, which is a good idea, at least in my opinion, but you don't have to if you don't really want to. And then of course I'm gonna do a rescan, and now I should have no vulnerabilities whatsoever. So I'm gonna go to rescan here, and of course it will take into consideration my filters, and it says that there is nothing wrong, yay. So the scan hasn't found anything suspicious, and is definitely great. So yeah, definitely get the application, it's completely free, it got a lot of updates, and yes, it's created by myself, iDevice Central. So yes, if you are jailbroken, definitely a great application to have, and I keep updating it regularly. So yeah, thank you for watching. I am GSnow. Till the next time, subscribe to stay updated, and peace out.